Welcome back, Rashida, to our second episode of Light Inner Flame. In the last episode, we spoke about Akashic Records and how they are useful to people to solve their present and past problems. Today, let us talk about our Light Inner Flame itself. What is this flame that you wish to light?
First, thank you for having me. Light Inner Flame is basically, it means that we are all a divine spark. The Creator has created all of us for His own being, and we are all a part of that divine being, the Creator. So that we are already a divine spark, but somehow over the centuries, with our conditioning of human life, we have somewhere forgotten that we are actually a divine spark. So the idea is to light that inner flame that we already having burning inside us. Let it, to acknowledge that, to be aware of that, to make it grow and radiate from right from within us. That is the whole purpose of lighting the inner flame that we already have burning inside
us. What is the first step? What does one do to start this process?
First of all is to accept that we are a divine spark. And then important thing is to be aware of this life that we are living. Every little thing that we experience, that we see, that we hear through all our senses, to the people that we meet, the conversation that we have, is to be aware of it, that all this is happening, that we are doing something, and there is some divine purpose to this whole life that we are leading. Understand this, and to understand that, to see how we are using our body, our mind, a way of thinking, a way of working. Once we get aware of that, then we know that, okay, there is something already inside us, that knowledge, that understanding of this human life, how we deal with ourselves, with others. That's how this awareness is created within us. That's how we know that, okay, we are a divine spark, and now how to use the spark within us, not only for ourselves, but to make it, let it shine for others around us. That is the whole purpose of our life. It comes true. It lights up our path, our soul path that we are supposed to live and serve.
Can you elaborate more on the soul part?
There is a purpose to every life that has been created by the divine, right? So each one has some purpose. Now, we have gone through many lifetimes, been conditioned by lot of relationships, to soul contracts, through karmas that we call about. So somewhere along the line, we have forgotten, but every soul has a purpose to serve. And that is where the idea is, to serve that purpose through whatever we are living as. It may be through our relationships, through our work, through the struggles, through even the happy moments that we enjoy, the nature, the Mother Earth, the abundance that we enjoy so easily. All that has to understand that, what is my purpose that I'm here on this earth? What do I really need to do? And how is it that even if I don't know the purpose, how can I still serve it by sharing it with others? My life, my time, my space, being grateful for the nature that we have around us, not take it for granted. That in itself is serving a purpose. That is connecting us to each other easily.
So what you're saying, Rashida, is that all of us here, and this we spoke about in Akashic Records also, is here for a purpose. And we have chosen to be born in this particular life, in this particular body, and with the particular surrounding which we have chosen. And we have chosen this to perform a task or several tasks, and to make our, improve our karma and solve our karma and solve the soul contracts which have not been completed. And we have to go forward in that. And the first thing we have to do is to accept this fact and to be aware that, yes, we are here for a certain purpose.
Yeah, it's true that we are here for a purpose, but we cannot live a lone life on this earth, right? We have to have people around us to interact with, to communicate on a certain level, on a certain degree, in a certain way. And only through those experiences is that learning can happen. Even to serve the purpose, we should have the knowledge. How do we get that knowledge? By interacting with other people. Each one is going through something. If we understand that and we are there to for each other, supporting each other. That's how the learning actually happens. So even karmas are not supposed to be negative or something to be do away with. It is basically, it's a way of learning only. That is an interaction. If there is a problem, why is the problem? How can we resolve that situation? Or if it is a good situation, then how can we learn from it and grow? So soul contracts, karmas, these are all part of our learning and growing to be able to use our very own spiritual muscle to really serve the purpose. To serve the purpose also, you have to, it's like you want to graduate and do something for yourself, but you have to go to the kindergarten, you have to go to school, you have to go to college, you have to acquire a certain skill and ability so that you can work for the future purpose that you wish to create, right? So it's a similar thing. The soul has to undergo through so many things, so many processes of learning, that you can actually serve the purpose. But on the way, when you're learning, even in school, college, you don't give up living that one day I will do it, right? You're still living your life, you're still interacting, you're learning and growing and enjoying at the same time. So even if you fall or if you have a problem or a trauma, you try to come out of it, learn from there as to where you went wrong or how you can correct it or how you can overcome that and move forward in life, leaving it behind. Similarly, this is also a school. The life that we are living is also a school. We have to learn from there and continue living from there. This journey itself is a soul path. It is not about the final destination. This life itself is a journey which is also learning and which is also a soul purpose that we are already living it. It's just a matter of understanding, accepting it and being aware of it, that we are already doing that. With awareness, it becomes easier. It is wonderful. It is enjoyable too. Now that we know what we are going through and why we are going
through. What is the other way of creating this awareness?
Basically, of course, when you go further on the path, you can meditate, you can do some spiritual reading, be with the masters. But on a day-to-day life also, in a simple way, you can be really aware of what is happening with you. How are you interacting with other people? What is your mindset at that point of time? Or how are you reacting to people or your work or your situation in life, or how you're doing the little thing with joy or happiness, or it is a burden for you? These little things, when you get aware of them and then you do that with awareness and acceptance, and most importantly, you take it as a learning for you. And it is, you can even do things even when you don't like them. If you still do it with wholeheartedness, you'll be surprised. You'll, by the end of the day, you will in fact start enjoying it. You will do it more better. And people can tell, oh, what perfection, like, you know. So it is just a matter of being aware of wherever you are, whatever you're doing, with whomever you are. You accept it and you enjoy it, rather than having grumbles and complaints against it. Then you'll never know that that moment could have been actually a part of your enjoyment. Okay. That's the whole simple thing. Awareness is the first step to your spirituality, to serving your purpose in the rightful way.
Awareness seems to be the first step to a lot of things. Is it very easy to be aware?
Yeah, it is so simple. When you brush your teeth, instead of thinking of here and there, can't you just brush your teeth in awareness that, okay, I'm brushing my teeth left to right, right to left, or I'm eating food. What is the taste of the food? What is the texture of the food? You know, how does it, what is the smell that, you know, what kind of a food that I'm eating? Be aware of that. What kind of a plate I'm eating in? What? How is the color? We normally live unaware. We just eat. We don't really enjoy not only the food, but not even our surroundings. We go to a restaurant to enjoy the ambience by paying for it. Imagine, but if you were to do that on a day-to-day basis for every little thing, that awareness, if it is on every little bit of level that you live, even a simple thing is like walking past on the footpath, you're watching a dog play or a child smile, or, you know, a flower growing in some corner, you know, somewhere, a weed maybe, but just to enjoy that. We see a cloud passing by. When we see a rainbow, we feel happy. But besides the rainbow, there are so many other things to really see and enjoy on a day-to-day basis. That awareness will allow you to live in the present, no matter what happened in the past, no matter what's going to happen in the future. But awareness allows you, not only allows you, but it makes you really live your life in the present and enjoy it. That is the whole purpose, that awareness comes, makes you live in the now. And that present is really a gift, and enjoy it right now. It is not going to come again, that moment. That awareness itself becomes a joy to live your life. Then whether you're serving the purpose or so is not important. You are anyway doing it because you are really appreciating the gift of the nature of your life, the body that you have, the mind that you are thinking from, the surroundings that you have, the relationships that you have, all become a part of your, not only your soul purpose, but you're enjoying it along with that. Because you are living in the here and now. Right here, right now.
Thank you very much, Rashida, for this little bit of nugget of information. And I'm sure our audience will love to hear more about this.
It was entirely my pleasure. Thank you very much. You too have a great day.